Just last week I told you,
I don't break down anymore. Used to, we sang many songs, me and Trish. And come up on the radio, I have to park the car because I cannot drive anymore. That's all the graduate, those things. And you mentioned about look for me. When you practicing here with your son, this is a true story. I had, I think it was early part of this year or maybe last year sometime, I came to preach and you were there some reason. I know it's reason. And I was so impressed. I would just sneak up this iPhone like this and take a film. And happened, I was watching harmonizer, and also I had some film in my iPhone, not the video camera. So I looked for that iPhone and I found that upgrade out. And I was watching how to get in touch with Jimmy so I can put in the website. And you opened the door this morning, I was so excited. Mm-hmm. You're going to do that. And you mentioned about it for me. I thought, wow. I'm telling you, there's a night me and Trish sang this song so many times in our bedroom. Just to make a message to our heart, just me and Trish. We did a special. So many times, weddings and funerals, and I don't have any of the Trish singing with me, because if I film it, we're not singing, yes, obviously. But this, the song, is just for me, that is the our theme song we're going to get. The true story. If this life only, Paul said, I'm most miserable. But I believe there's a life beyond this life.
Amen.
Start singing again. Amen. On both sides. All right. I don't know what to do. Let's open the John chapter 1. Is John chapter 1 verse 50. Jesus answered and said to him, because I said to you that I saw you under the fig tree, do you believe? You shall see greater things than these. You shall see greater things than these. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we come to you. You bless us. My heart already uplift my soul to beyond. The song of the message was sound of the joy, Lord, touched our heart. So now, let me speak your word
Let me make the message
you want us to hear.
Lord, every time we are in the darkness, we look for you. Look for your name and your presence. Lord, so heal our heart. Heal our community. Heal the land. Yes, Lord, we pray. Thank you for the great service already. Let me give this message unto you and my heart. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. This is great, great message. I believe, since I got the license plate, did you see my, I'm parking the truck around? Do you know the reason? Because I want to show off that license plate that said, believe. PineyGoldLewisville.org. Yes. I Googled it this morning, PineyGoldLewisville.org. They still ask me, do you mean PineyGoldLewisville? I ignore that question and click that. It comes up, my website all over the place. Yes. You should do that. Now Google knows whether Piney Grove Baptist Church in Lewisville. Yeah. Brother Fred is playing the harmonica and all the playwright pictures. Oh my goodness. Yes, wonderful. But we believe there is the reason we believe. I want to make some message for a long, long time. Down this way. I'm getting excited.
Amen.
I'm content. So bear with me. But we believe there's a reason for that, right? Okay. So Jesus said to Nathanael, yes, I saw you before you saw me. Is that the reason you follow me? If it's so, no, there's a greater things you're going to find out. And we gather here, there is some reason we believe. Book of John starts, John the Baptist. Go back to the verse 35. Again, the next day, John the Baptist standing with two of his disciples and looked upon Jesus as he walked and said, behold, the Lamb of God. This is John the Baptist's word, said, behold, the Lamb of God. And the two disciples heard John the Baptist speak. They followed Jesus. And Jesus turned and beheld them following and said to them, what do you seek? And they said to him, Rabbi, where are you staying? This is New American Standard. I like this translation. It said, where are you staying? King James Version, it said, where thou dwell. Dwelling place. Jesus did not have a dwelling place. He was wandering. There's no dwelling place in Jesus. Jesus' dwelling place? Up yonder. Over yonder. Great place. But here, he stayed one place, he stayed another place. Me and Trish came here 11 years ago, and all the students asked me, where you stay? What? Yeah, where you stay? Okay, I don't live, you just stay. That's what they see. They ask, where you stay? I want to be with you. But the question is, it says verse 38, Rabbi, and my Bible says, which translate means teacher. teacher, right? So Jesus answered and said, come and you will see. They came, therefore, they saw where he was staying, and they stayed with him that day. And it was about the 10th hour. One of the two who heard John speak that followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He found first his own brother, Simon, and said to him, we have found Messiah. Now, Andrew called Jesus Rabbi, right? Verse 38. And just three verses later, told his brother, I found Messiah, which translates Christ. Now, what happened?
He
believed. He had experience. Now, what you need, to experience Jesus Christ. This has come from my wife's first cousin, put it on the Facebook. I believe God not because my parents told me, not because the church told me, but because I've experienced His goodness and mercy myself. See, that's the difference. You can call Jesus, but you can call Jesus as a teacher, Sunday school teacher, or do you call Jesus Christ, my Lord, my Savior? See the difference? You gotta have that difference. That's the reason Jesus said, you will find the greater things in my name, in my presence. You got own it. I like the word claim. Baptist won't say, you got claim, right? I know that's a different denomination, but I like that, claim. So open the Mark. Mark chapter 5. This is a lady about in the city for a long, long, long time. Book of Mark chapter 5, verse 25. Mark chapter 5, verse 25. And the woman who had had homage in 12 years and endured much of the hard of many physicians and had spent all that she had and was not helped, but rather had grown worse. Verse 27. After hearing about Jesus, came up in the crowd behind him and touched his cloak. For he quit, number 28, for she thought, if I just touch his garment, I shall get well. I shall get well. Now listen, you heard Jesus all your life. Maybe. I never heard Jesus' name until I was 24. I never experienced Jesus' name. But here, she heard Jesus gonna be come around. Okay, only difference here is when she heard, she act, get up, and went to the place where Jesus was. Remember the disciple asked, where you stay? I want to stay with you. Same thing right here. She went to Jesus' place. Then what? She touched his garment. Why? Because she believed only I touched his garment, I will heal. See, this action comes with not just listen to the name, but you take forward the step. You do something with Jesus Christ, toward Jesus Christ, in Jesus Christ, then things happen. And immediately, verse 29, the flow of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body. She was healed of her affliction. And immediately Jesus perceived that himself, that the power proceeding from him had gone forth, turned around in the crowd and said, "Who touched my garment?" I always tell you people, if Jesus asks a question, it's always a trick question, right? Jesus knows the answer, but he's asking you. Look at big mouth Peter saying. Next verse. And it said, his disciples said to him, "You see the multitude pressing in on you? You say, who touched me?" Jesus lives all over the place, bumping all over the place. What do you mean, who touched you? Okay, that's the reason Jesus asked. The touch is the difference. Many people come to church. Yes, I go to church. All my life I went to church. You go to church. Do you experience Jesus? You gotta be. See, if you are the church goer, go to church, experience Jesus Christ. Don't go to church to catch up the gossip. That's not the way the church operates. Jesus is asking you, why you go to church? Scary question, isn't it? Jesus asked, the reason is verse 33. But the woman fearing and trembling, aware of what had happened to her, came and fell down before him and told him the whole truth. Jesus, I needed you. I know this is wrong, but I came behind and I touched your garment because I wanted to heal. I wanted to be the full of my life. I needed you. Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your affliction." I like King James. Thy faith made thee whole. Not only the physical healing, but the spirit filled. You made a whole life. That's what you need with Jesus Christ. If you come to Jesus Christ, let's experience Jesus Christ. Let's feel Jesus Christ. Let's touch the garment of His. So we will heal. Do that. Let's all stand.